हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट अमाइंस। सो अमाइंस आर नाइट्रोजन कंटेनिंग कंपाउंड्स, ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स विच आर हैविंग बेसिक कैरेक्टर एंड दीज आर प्रेजेंट इन द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ मेनी नेचुरल कंपाउंड्स लाइक प्रोटीन्स, विटामिन्स, हॉर्मोन्स एंड एज वेल एज मेनी प्लांट प्रोडक्ट्स लाइक निकोटीन ऑल्सो। यस, एंड दीज आर कंसिडर्ड एज अ अल्किल और अरिल डेरिवेटिव्स ऑफ अमोनिया। ओके, so as this these are considered as a alkyl or aryl derivatives of ammonia, in which one, two or the three hydrogen atoms which are attached to the nitrogen are replaced by same or different alkyl or aryl groups. Okay, and these are classified on the basis of number of hydrogen atoms of ammonia that are replaced by alkyl or aryl groups. Okay, and the first type is primary amine. Let's consider the first type, that is primary amine. Okay, so in the primary amines, only one hydrogen atom of ammonia is replaced by alkyl or aryl groups. Okay, and it is represented by like this. And the general representation is RnH2. By replacing one hydrogen atom by alkyl group, these are turned into RnH2. Okay, and this group is called as amino group. Yes. Now let's consider simple example for primary amine. In this case, one hydrogen atom of ammonia gets replaced by methyl group. Okay, so this will be methyl amine. Yes. In this case, one hydrogen atom is replaced by ethyl group. So this will be ethyl amine. Yes. Here, one hydrogen atom is replaced by phenyl group. We are familiar with this amine, that is aniline. So these are the examples, some examples for the primary amine. Yes, in this case, one hydrogen atom of ammonia gets replaced by the corresponding alkyl or aryl group. Yes, and here the general representation for primary amine is RnH2. And this group is called as amino group. Now let's consider the second type, that is secondary amines. Okay, so in this case, two hydrogen atoms of ammonia are replaced by two same or different alkyl or aryl groups. Yes. Now let's consider first general representation. These are denoted by 2 degree. So the functional group for this will be R2NH. And this is called as imino group. Yes, this group is called as imino group. Now let's consider simple examples. In this case, the two hydrogen atoms of ammonia gets replaced by alkyl groups. Okay, so this is the example for secondary amine. So in this case, two alkyl groups which are attached to the nitrogen are different. These are methyl group and ethyl group. So the name for this compound will be ethyl methyl amine. Yes. In this example, see, the two hydrogen atoms of ammonia gets replaced by alkyl and aryl group. So this will be also the example for secondary amine. Now let's consider the third type, that is tertiary amine. Okay, so into the tertiary amines, three hydrogen atoms of ammonia are replaced by three same or different alkyl or aryl groups. Okay, and these are represented as R3N. Yes, and this group is called as tertiary nitrogen. Now let's consider simple examples. See, in this example, three hydrogen atoms of ammonia gets replaced by three alkyl groups. Yes, so here three same alkyl groups are attached, which are methyl group. So this is called as trimethyl amine. This will also be the example of tertiary amine. In this case, the two hydrogen atoms are replaced by alkyl group and one hydrogen is replaced by aryl group. So this will also be the example for tertiary amine. Yes. Okay, so these are the three types for amines, which are depending on the number of hydrogen atoms of ammonia that are replaced by alkyl or aryl groups. Yes, into the primary amine, only one hydrogen atom is replaced by corresponding alkyl or aryl group, and the group is called as amino group. Into the secondary amine, two hydrogen atoms are replaced by corresponding alkyl or aryl group, and the group is called as amino group. And in case of tertiary amine, three hydrogen atoms of ammonia gets replaced by alkyl or aryl group. Yes, and this group is called as, it is represented by R3N, and is called as tertiary nitrogen. Yes, clear? Now in case of secondary and tertiary amine, more than one alkyl group is present, so these are further classified as simple or symmetrical amines and mixed or unsymmetrical amines. Okay, now first consider the type simple amines. These are also called as symmetrical amines. So in this case, same alkyl groups are attached to the nitrogen. Let's consider simple example. This is the example for secondary amine, because two hydrogen atoms are replaced by alkyl groups. Yes, now here two alkyl groups which are attached to the nitrogen are same, so this is the example for simple or symmetrical amine. Yes, two alkyl groups which are attached are ethyl groups, so this will be diethyl amine. Yes, this will be the example for tertiary amine, and in this case the hydrogen atoms replaced by the corresponding alkyl groups, and here the alkyl groups which are attached to the nitrogen atom are same. Okay, so this will be also the example of simple or symmetrical amines. Yes, and here three methyl groups are attached to the nitrogen, so this will be trimethyl amine. Yes, now let's consider the second type, that will be mixed or unsymmetrical amines. Okay, now in this case the different alkyl groups are attached to the nitrogen. Now let's consider simple examples. This is the example for tertiary amine, and to the nitrogen atom different alkyl groups are attached. Okay, so this will be the example for mixed or unsymmetrical amine. In this case, two ethyl groups are attached and one methyl group is attached. So this will be diethyl methyl amine. This will be the example of secondary amine, which is mixed amine. Because in this case, two different alkyl groups are attached to the nitrogen. One is ethyl group and one is methyl group. Okay, so this will be ethyl methyl amine. Okay, so in this case, secondary and tertiary amines are classified as simple amines and mixed amine. Simple amines are also called as symmetrical amine, and in this case, same alkyl groups are attached to the nitrogen. And in case of mixed amine, different alkyl groups are attached to the nitrogen. And mixed amines are also called as unsymmetrical amines. Clear? Next, we'll consider some IUPAC names for the amines. So these are some examples for the primary amines. And in IUPAC system, the primary amines are named by replacing E of the parent alkane by amine. Okay, so the IUPAC name for the primary amine will be E of the alkane gets replaced by amine. So this will be IUPAC name for the primary amine will be alkanamine. Yes. Now let's consider this example. Now in this case, the carbon chain consists of only one carbon atom. So corresponding alkane will be methane. So E of the methane gets replaced by amine. So this will be methanamine. Okay. And the common name for this will be methylamine, because to the methyl group, amino group is attached. Yes, so this will be methylamine, and IUPAC name for this will be methanamine. Yes, now let's consider the second example. Now in this case, longest carbon chain consists of three carbon atoms. Okay, and amino group is attached to the N propyl group. Yes, so this will be N propyl amine. Yes, and IUPAC name for this will be, it will be propanamine. We'll insert the position of carbon atom to which amino group is attached. Okay, so this will be propan-1-amine. Okay, because to the first carbon atom, amino group is attached. Yes, next, in the similar way, we'll give numbering to the longest carbon chain, consists of three carbon atom, and amino group is attached to isopropyl group. So this will be isopropyl amine. Yes, so as once again the longest carbon chain consists of three carbon atom, this will be propanamine, and to the second carbon atom amino group is attached. Okay, so this will be propan 2 amine. Yes. Next, now consider this case. In this case, consider longest carbon chain consists of two carbon atoms. Yes. And in this case, two functional groups are present. So before writing amine, we will write diamine. Yes. So two carbon atom means this is the alkane which is having two carbon atom is ethane. We'll write for the begin the name with the ethane. Position is amino group is attached to first and second carbon atom. So this will be 1,2-diamine. Okay. Next, longest carbon chain consists of three carbon atoms. Yes. Now in this case, double bonded carbon atom is there. Okay, so this will be propenamine. Hmm? position for the double bond is second. So we'll insert this two. Next, the position of amino group is one. So this will be propenamine. Next, now see in this example, the longest carbon chain consists of six carbon atom. Okay, six CH2 groups are present. So longest carbon chain consists of six carbon atom, and this amino groups are attached to the first and sixth carbon atom. So once again, it will be diamine. As six carbon atoms are present, so the alkane having six carbon atom is hexane. To the first and sixth position, amino group is attached, so this will be hexane 1,6 diamine. Okay. In this case, amino group is attached to the benzene. Okay, so this is called as benzenamine. E of the benzene gets replaced by amine. So this will be either benzenamine or this is also called as aniline. Yes. Now in the next example, first give numbering 1, 2, 3 and 4. To the fourth position, methyl group is attached. Okay. And this is aniline. To the aniline, methyl group is attached to the fourth position. Okay. So this will be 4-methyl-aniline. Okay. Or instead of writing aniline, we can write benzenamine also. Yes. Next. Now in this case, this will be, this is called as benzyl amine. Okay. Because to the benzyl group, amino group is attached. So this will be benzyl amine. Now in case of IUPAC name, now we'll consider this as a CH3. So one hydrogen for hydrogen of CH3 gets replaced by amino group. Yes. So this is actually phenyl methane, that is toluene we called it as. Okay. So the one hydrogen atom of phenyl methane gets replaced by amino group. So this will be phenyl methanamine. Okay, now see in this case, once again we'll give numbering 1, 2, 3 and 4. To the fourth position, bromine is attached. So this will be 4-bromoaniline. Or instead of writing aniline, we can write benzenamine also. So this will be 4-bromobenzenamine also. Yes, now in this case, amino group is attached to the cyclohexane. So this will be cyclohexanamine. E of the hexane gets replaced by amine. Okay, clear? Next, these are some examples for the secondary amine. And in case of secondary and tertiary amine, these are named as a N substituted derivatives of primary amines. Okay. And in this case, see, two alkyl groups are present. Okay. So the largest alkyl groups, which is attached to the nitrogen, is taken as a parent alkane. And the another alkyl group, it will be considered as a N substituent. Yes. Now in this case, to the NH or to the nitrogen, two methyl groups are attached. Yes. So the common name for this will be dimethylamine. Yes. And for the IUPAC name, we'll consider 1-methyl as a substituent and 1-methyl as a parent, or 1 carbon atom as a parent alkane. Okay. Now we'll consider this as a substituent. So this will be N substituent. So we'll write it as N methyl. If we consider this as a substituent, this will be methanamine. Yes. In this case, two alkyl groups which are attached to the nitrogen are different. Yes. This is the largest carbon chain. We'll consider this as a parent alkene and this CH3 as a substituent. Okay. So this will be, or the common name for this will be ethyl methyl amine, and the IUPAC name will be, substituent is methyl. So once again, this will be N methyl. Yes. Longest carbon chain consists of two carbon atoms. So this will be ethanamine. Yes. In this case, to the nitrogen, one methyl group is attached and one phenyl group is attached. Okay. So this will be, or the common name for this will be methyl phenyl amine. Yes. And in case of IUPAC name, we'll consider this methyl group as a substituent. So this will be N methyl. We'll consider this as a aniline or benzenamine. Yeah. So this will be N methyl aniline, or we can also write it as a N methyl benzenamine. Yes. Now in this case, to the nitrogen, two phenyl groups are attached. Okay, so the common name for this will be diphenylamine. Now we'll consider one phenyl as a substituent. Yes, we'll consider this as a substituent. This will be N phenyl. And we'll consider this as a benzenamine. Okay, so this will be N phenyl benzenamine. Clear? Next, these are some examples for the tertiary amine. And in case of tertiary amine, to the nitrogen, three alkyl groups are attached, out of which two alkyl groups are will considered as a N substituent, and the longest the alkyl group which is having longest carbon chain will consider it as a parent alkene. Yes. Now in the first example, three alkyl groups which are attached are methyl groups. Yes. So the common name for this will be trimethylamine. Yes. Now we'll consider two methyl group as a substituent. So this will be, as here two substituents are attached, so we'll write N. Okay, two methyl groups are there, so this will be NN dimethyl. Once again, this will be methanamine. Yes, in this case, the substituents will consider these two groups, methyl groups, as a substituent. And in this case, C2H5 will consider this as a parent compound. Okay, so as here one ethyl and two methyl groups are attached, the common name will be ethyl dimethyl amine. Yes, and IUPAC name will be, substituents are two methyl groups, so this will be N dimethyl ethanamine. Next, in this case, the alkyl groups which are attached to the nitrogen are methyl group, ethyl group, and propyl group. Yes, so this will be ethyl methyl N propylamine. Now we'll consider methyl and ethyl group as a N substituent. So this will be N ethyl and methyl. Okay, we'll consider here, alphabetically E comes first, so we'll give priority to the ethyl group. Yes, as here longest carbon chain consists of 3 carbon atoms, so this will be propanamine. Yes, N ethyl and methyl propanamine. Okay, next, in this example the alkyl groups which are attached to the nitrogen are ethyl group, methyl group and isopropyl group. Okay, so the common name for this will be ethyl methyl isopropyl amine. Yes, now we'll consider ethyl and methyl group as a substituent. So this will be alphabetically ethyl comes first, so we'll give priority to the ethyl group. So this will be N ethyl and methyl. Give numbering to this carbon chain. Two nitrogen atom is attached to the second carbon atom. So this will be propan 2-amine. Yes, so this will be N ethyl N methyl propan 2-amine. Yes. Now in this example the alkyl groups, one aryl group is also present. So this will be 2 methyl groups are attached to the aniline, so this will be NN dimethyl aniline. Okay, or it can be also known as benzenamine. Yes, so the IUPAC name will be, we'll consider 2 methyl as a substituent. So this will be NN dimethyl. And these are attached to the benzenamine or aniline. Okay, so these are the IUPAC names for primary, secondary and tertiary amines. Clear?